All right, welcome back. And yeah, we've completed the labyrinth now, and Mori was so impressed with the job that his minions did that he's decided that he wants them to build him a mansion right next door. And well, unfortunately, we don't have any mansions. We have the large residences, and there's a new large residence as well. Let's have a look at that. Yeah, sort of more wooden style. Let's turn this around so you can have a look. Yeah, it's a nice model. It's nice to have another large residence as opposed to the white colonial style ones that we have in the vanilla game. Well, still, I don't think they're impressive enough for Mori, and yeah, we actually have. Let's have a look. Yeah, we have some castles, so I'm thinking that would be good enough for Mori. So we'll set about building him his mansion and the grounds around it. So yeah, let's have a go at that. Okay. So we're just going to extend the road along the front of the labyrinth. In fact, actually, yeah, that's a bit... Yeah, that's not flat there, so let's flatten this off just before we get going. Okay, that should do it. Let's see what these traders have brought. Food, we don't need food, go away. Strawberry seeds, yeah, we asked for those, didn't we? So let's take that. Trade, let's knock this off. What are the berries we got? Raspberries, that'll do. Okay, let's get rid of this, and yeah, we'll extend this roadway a little bit. I do quite like the sort of swathes of brickwork on the floor. It does look good. And yeah, now another one of the mods in Red Ketchup's New Medieval Towns includes canals, and every castle should have sort of a moat around it. So there were two different textures to choose from, and three different sizes. So I think we're just going to go for. Let's have a look. Yes, this is with the New Medieval Towns 1.1b. This texture, and we're just going to go for the four wide canal, and yeah, a number of different. Joiners, connections. We've even got fishing docks, and we can put trading posts on these canals as well. So I think for the moat, though, we're not going to have anything on that, so we're just going to run that around. We'll start with a couple of bridges, and again, the bridges are cyclable as well, so different styles of models. I think we're going to go for the brick with the brick sides. Yeah, so let's swing a couple of these down, and it's the second from left is the straight piece. Yeah, so I'm just looking now, it looks like, yeah, this is quite hilly as well, so let's try and just remove some of these trees, and then we'll flatten this area a little bit. Why is everyone moving slowly? Is typhus. We've got a disease. We've got a physician in, so I'll leave him to deal with that. Yeah, let's get rid of these trees. And we'll speed the game back up again. And prioritize. Okay. are we doing for labourers? 21 labourers, so 10 builders. So yeah, it's about right. Should be enough to get some of these trees moved. Let's start on the other side. And just take it a bit further up this way. We've got another trader. Let's check out. See what he's got. More fish. Has he got fish? No. Seal meat. Strawberry soup. Yeah, you can get soups now as food, and you can actually make your own through the soup kitchen. Where's that? Well, I'm not sure. Yeah, there's that many new icons that it sometimes takes a while. I think this is a soup kitchen. Spin this round for you to have a look. Yeah, it's a nice little model. Just a little shack, a couple of little ovens, and yeah, you can make different types of soup. So again, when we place that, we'll have a look at that in a bit more detail. But for now, dismiss. Okay. How are you getting on moving these trees? Okay, I think we're just gonna flatten this. Oh, wrong button. And then prioritize clearing this space. Oh, and look what I've done. It's just, I forgot that it cycles to the next model if you place them consecutively. So we're gonna have to get rid of that because that just will not do. Now, if you're removing these canals, it leaves a hole. So you can either use the flatten terrain tool, or actually, in the Red Ketchup's menu, there's a little tool here which will just flatten it again. Let's try that again, but be a little bit tighter. Spacing. I think it's those logs that's stopping it from working, but that'll get done in a second. So, and did I wipe my thing away here? I did, didn't I? Oh, it's a nightmare. Let's try that again. Yeah, what's this tray that got? Oh, there's two. Olive seeds. Yeah, we'll take those. In fact, I just want to make sure I don't have them already. A quick way of doing that is just click on. Actually, no olives. Yeah, they'll be an orchard, which I don't have yet, so. Oh, I'm just going to buy them. Trade. Anything else specifically? Any open space anywhere? I'm just gonna try and put a small standard orchard in so I can click on it and see what we've got already. Yeah, so olives. So. Go back to the traders. And I'll take figs, because again we'll need those if we're wanting to brew some spirits. And yeah, you can go. Okay. So yeah, that tool's does the same thing as the flat terrain tool. It's sorted all this section out. Looks like they're nearly done. Get that tree down. And there we go. Okay. So I'll remove that and that, and then let's try and put this bridge back in. And get the right one this time. There we go. And then we'll just extend this out. Okay, so I'm just going to flip this around now, see what we're doing. Now, yeah, with the castles, you can also build some walls and such around it. So it's like a flat wall piece, like a tower, corner piece, and some gates. So yeah, let's throw some gates down. Yeah, if you spin these round, you've got to make sure they're pointing the right way. They've got some, they've got like a place for the arches to stand, so we want that facing inwards. So we'll just put a couple on each side. Wanga tower down. Now the tower's got stained glass windows on three sides. Apart from one, which has got that, so I'm just going to have that facing inwards. And those are the flat pieces either side. And we'll throw a corner piece on. Great, okay. So, yeah, let's make some walls to protect Murray's mansion. Just gonna rinse and repeat, really. I'm just gonna check for my windows. There we go. I'm just gonna put one length, I think, on this front edge. Just because I want a bit of space in the corners, but I don't necessarily need it on the sides. So. And then we'll throw in the gates. As long as the arrows are pointing sort of forward, that should be the exterior. Running into the age-old problem of trees being in the way, so let's ask him to clear this out so I can see what I'm doing. Yeah, another trader. They come thick and fast when you're running on times 10, but again, you need to get things done. Food, again, that's all he seems to be bringing me at the moment, so annoying. Let's see if we can extend this top piece. Where are we looking? Where are we looking? Here we go. Okay, so one, two, pretty much three sides done. Just finish off the fourth side. This up there. Let's get the tower in. And then two along this side. There before the entrance. Two. And then yep. Another entrance on this side. All nice and level. Two more walls. A tower. More wall, and then that corner piece should fit snugly into this gap. Hopefully, yeah, lovely. Okay, so we've got our perimeter walls for Murray's mansion, and I mean, to be honest, the grounds are so big, he's not going to have to walk far at all. So, yeah, we should be okay with the effects of the fountain. Let's just make sure everything's been cleared out of the centre of here, and we'll flatten the terrain in here as well, just to give us a nice even surface. I'm wiping it with the wrong thing, here we go. Okay, it all shifted. Okay. Let's see if we can extend this canal a little bit around the outside of the perimeter wall. So times four, let's give it a bit of extra length. See, again, it's still a bit. Yeah. Before I do that, I think to just say that we've got nice, clean edges on the canal walls, and we're gonna flatten just the area around the perimeter wall. So let's get that done. Okay, so yeah, this might take a little bit of a time to get all this flattened. We're now on 102 items need building, so yeah, quite a lot. And we're completely out of stone, which I didn't notice, so yeah, we better get some of that in. Just give me all the stone. Oh, there's a big crop of it up here. Yeah, loads of it. Okay, so that's pretty much going to be trickling in. As regards to the this grow your own resources sort of tree farm we've got, it's over in the corner of Ash Forks. Look at that, that's really nice. We can do the same with stone, iron, and coal as well, I think. Can I just check that? What have we got? We've got stone shack, yeah, iron shack, coal shack, and tree shack. So yeah, we could try putting a stone shack down. See what that does. Yeah, why not? Okay. I don't want to get in the way of the golden llama. But I don't want it to be too far away from the town either. Let's be brave, let's just throw it down there. I'm just going to extend this road as well, just so they're not messing about. Get into the shacks, stone and tree. I'll wait till that's built before I put the house in, just so I can see what I'm doing. Okay, let's take a recap, see what's going on. So, we're at our fuel limit again, so let's raise that to 30,000. Yeah, chapel, how many people have we got? We've got 77, 90, 106, so yeah, 80, so we're we're needing, basically. A new parish house or church. How's the school doing? 14 students, so we're okay for the school at the moment. What can we put down? Let's put another parish house in, just to keep them happy. Everything seems fine. Happiness, 4.5, sort of been that way all the way, so. But, yeah, we'll put another chapel in. Parish house, I should say. Let's just put this here. What else needs doing? Not a lot, really. Not a lot. Still waiting for these cows. Taking their time. It's 28 years in. Herb guys seem to be doing okay. We've got 17,000 herbs. We can actually start to use the herbs at the trading post, really, if we need to, because they're worth the same as the firewood. So, and they're probably pretty comparable in terms of the amounts we've got for each as well. So, what are they actually producing? Yeah, 600-ish. So not bad for one guy each. There should be 7 in there. So. Yeah. Okay. Let's go and have a look at see what's going on over here. They're doing all right clearing this area. That shouldn't take too long. Looks like putting the canal in there as well. In fact, I think they've just done it. So let's get rid of that bit and get a couple of bridges on this side. Just sticking to four-way all the way around. And yeah, as long as it matches up, it's pretty tight onto the wall here, so I'm just going to use it there. Just to make sure I've got the right model again. I make the same mistake twice. So I'm sure I will. And 1, 2, 3, I think it is. Yeah, 3. Okay, we've got the bridges down. Let's extend out. I've got to say, these canals are amazing. When you consider what we put around this angel monument here, I mean, there's just no comparison, is it really? So yeah, kudos to Red Ketchup. Trader. Have you got wine? No, we don't want wine. Make our own later. Yeah, I think the side's done as well, so let's get the canal in here. Let's remove this first. The only downside with these canals is there's so many menus to get through just to choose what you want, so. And sometimes you get in the way when you're trying to put them down. Continue to extend the canal right round. Just going to leave the corners because they can be a bit trickier. Let's sacrifice these herbs and final trees and get this centre section flattened down. I mean, the corners of these mods is just a little. I don't know. You just can't go right into the corner, so I'm just going to do two lines on either side, just to make sure it's all fully flat. There we go. Okay. And, this bit's done. so we can finalise this corner. Let's just check this trader. I want those cows. Food again. I think it's because I keep missing them, and then every time they come round, it's back to food again. No, but I'm going to specify on you to bring me some cows because I want them desperately. Go away. Okay, back through the menus. Yeah, let's try and fit this corner piece in now. So where would that go? That would go there. Guessing that's right. Okay, yeah, I think that's right. It looks like it's lined up correctly. So yeah, the normal straight piece, it's too wide to go in here. It's one piece, sort of three along. But there's a single filler section, so you can just fill those in with that. That neatens it up. How are you doing down here? I think that's done as well, so yeah, let's try and finish it all the way around. Yeah, our bridges. Straight pieces, and then just hopefully take them all to the end. Leave that for now, just to get a better look at it. Right, so and two filler pieces. Let's go here. Let's try and do this corner now. So that's lined up there. And then one normal piece on this side, and two filler pieces. Okay, that's just one corner to go. And then the last two filler pieces. Okay, great. So we've got our moat and our bridges, and yeah, they're beavering away to get this all flattened down. Let's try and prioritise that, and then we can place Morris Mansion in the centre. Okay. So yeah, all these sections have added up to quite a large number requiring to be built, 160. So yeah, if we can just get this centerpiece done, I'll put the castle in, and then see how they're getting along. Now with the fountain and the labyrinth, Murray's obviously got some guys guarding it 24/7. It's actually perceived to be quite a prestigious job, so I think we should give them some quite nice houses to go around the side of the labyrinth. Just keep watch over everything, make sure no one sneaks in. Yeah, okay, so how many can we fit in? One. Leave a space, two and a third, yeah. Let's do the same on the other side. Okay, very good. What do they need, actually? Stone, glass and bricks, yeah, so a good manoeuvre to get those on the go near the start of the game. Yeah, so we're just about balancing the families and the homes, so get a few more houses built, that should help us to move forward. Foods. Yeah, I think we might have to start producing a bit more food, or at least put a couple of guys into the fishing docks. So let's just do that while I remember. I'm going to be building some fields, I think, soon, so I think, again, just as a temporary measure before we can start to get a bit more variation in the diet of our minions. Oh, lovely, okay, they've cleared the centre. Okay, let's get rid. Now I just want to make sure this is all lined up correctly, so let's choose some white stone, I think, for the the mansion's grounds. Just going to throw in a couple of markers. In fact, actually, I've still got a couple of lines I need to remove, haven't I? Get rid of that one. Not so far in on this side. Yeah, I'll just put these in basically. So when I've got the model selected, it's a little bit easier to judge. In fact, I think I've hired it pretty damn well. Okay, let's punt at it. Let's stick that there and just make sure that's all right. Quick trader check. Bear seats. Why not? Trade, dismiss, got another one here. Maybe some cows, yes, we've got cows finally. Okay. Yeah, we can afford all them, so 6,000, 1,500 fire will be perfect. Okay, trade, dismiss. I'm going to tell them to keep bringing me cows, because I think we're going to fit more than six in here. 18, yeah, so another couple of traders should do the job. Look, there they go. Lovely. Okay. So, yeah, I think we're getting close to the end of this episode. It's coming along quite well. I've got the canal pretty much, the moat I should say, pretty much built around the side. Let's just put a bit more road in. Around the mansion. Just join this up. Stick with two. Yeah. Yeah, double road coming in from each side. I think I'm going to double up the road around the centre as well, just to create some nice proportions. Road down the sides, why not? Okay. You should see this thing, the stone castle, 250 logs, 450 stone, 80 iron, build 2,500, it's ridiculous. It's going to take probably a little bit of time to complete, especially because they're still building a lot of the moat around the exterior. But yeah, I think Warriors Mansions is coming along well, so yeah, we'll leave it there, and I'll see you next time in a bit.